Hi, everyone, and welcome to Virtual Co-Teaching Tips, episode number 8. My name's Ann Benninghoff, and I'm here with my good friend and colleague, Sonia Kunkel. How are you doing, Sonia?
I'm having a great day, Ann. Thanks for asking.
Good. Well, I know that we are ready to jump into another idea for all the co-teachers that are out there trying to figure out how to navigate this journey of virtual co-teaching. And we've been doing it ourselves for several months now. And so we wanted to share some ideas. So I think I'm up this time with an idea. Oh, no, actually, it's your turn. So your idea is about web questing. So tell me a little bit about that.
Well, you know, Anne, when you have two people that are co-teaching and one person is essentially doing some sort of lesson, mini lesson or lecturing, what can the other person be doing to reinforce the lesson? And when we're in the classroom and we're teaching together, I can write maybe a keyword on the board or draw a picture. Well, when we're working virtually, there are 5 things that we can do. Anne, you want to put those 5 things up for us?
Sure.
First, we can perhaps chat in a definition of a word. So right in the chat, you can do that. Or you can provide some synonyms for words. But some other things that would be associated with web questing would be to go out on the web and find something. As an example, you might look up the word mitosis and you might find an image or a picture and bring that into the classroom so that students have a sense of what that looks like as the teacher's talking about. Or you might even provide some level of translation. So going out on the web, finding little mini clips or little mini examples or visuals or synonyms, and then throwing them out there for students in the classroom to help support the lesson as it's going on. What do you think of that, Amy?
I love that because we also know that the research says that one of the ways to expand a deeper understanding of vocabulary is for students to explore synonyms and explore things in context and to look at images and add all of that. So all of that is going to increase their comprehension of any unknown words. So that's great. Good. I like that. Well, I want everybody to know that we have lots more ideas to share. And if you're interested in getting some more ideas, we're hoping you'll join us for our National Train the Trainer Institute, which will be January 19th through the 22nd. And Sonia, you and I have been doing this together for, gosh, 5 or 6 years now, I think. But July was the first time we had done it virtually. And we had so much fun, 4 full days packed with ideas and over, almost 200 people with us. And just everybody walked away with a whole lot of ideas. One of the things I'm excited to share this year is that I have been working on a new book on specially designed instruction. So people who attend in January will be getting some of those new ideas that are going into my book. So I'm looking forward to sharing those.
I think that that's wonderful, Anne. I've also learned a lot as a district person in terms of what we do on a day-to-day basis. So I'm excited to share these new ideas and also hear from our colleagues out there who will be joining us, because between all of us, we'll walk away with a ton of new ideas.
Great. Well, we hope you'll join us, everybody, and stay well and healthy and keep up the good work.
Thank you, everyone.